What's up, everyone? It's the Nomad Brad, and today we're going to be talking about how to make money online with Google AdWords in 2017. Specifically, where should you start? And I wanted to make this video to help people who are complete beginners, have never touched any ads at all, or maybe never touched AdWords, maybe don't even have a business yet, but you're thinking about it, and you just want to understand how AdWords works, how it can be a tool to use, or if you're already advanced, maybe you already have an established business, and you're just curious about how AdWords works and how it can make you more money, get you more customers, leads, and sales. So let's jump right in. I've got a few questions for you, and then I'm also gonna do like an overview of how AdWords works. So basically, there are five different ways to make money using Google Ads, and all of these different ways have different pluses and minuses, and each of them are going to be applicable to different types of businesses. So we're just gonna go over an overview so you know what all your options are and which one is the best place to start. And here in a couple of seconds, I'm gonna give you an exact place to start based on your answers to two different questions. So we've got five different places, networks that Google puts ads that it lets you access as a business. Number one is Google Search Ads. Number two, Google Display Network. Number three, remarketing audiences. Number four, YouTube ads. Number five, Google Shopping Ads. So we're gonna go over those real briefly and give you a good idea of which ones are most important to you and which ones you should start with right away to get the best chance for ROI, return on investment, and to be making profit right away. That's our focus today. So number one, Google Search Ads. These are the ads that you see whenever you search for something on Google itself. Then as you can see here, the paid ads are the ones that have that little ad thing next to it. And they will show above and below the organic search results. So this is the top organic search results for this search term, SEO training. These are keywords, by the way. We're going to be covering these later if you don't know what they are. This is how Google knows which ads to show you, because of it's based on which words you type into the search engine. So here are the paid ads. This is what you're actually going to be showing. You get to write these ads and design them for the people who are searching for different things. So we're going to cover this more later, but that is the Google Search Ad Network. Next, we have the Google Display Network. This is the ads that you see on blogs and websites all over the internet. You can see some examples here. This ad here is shown by Google. This ad here is shown by Google, and they will be distributed all over different blogs, websites that you're looking at. And so the cool thing is Google Display Network gives you access. You can put your own ads. You could create an image, and it will instantly be shown on, I don't know, maybe millions of websites, hundreds of thousands. There's a ton of websites. Google is like the most popular advertising network that helps websites monetize their ads. So they have access to millions of websites all over the world that you can show your ads on. And if those websites are a good match for your customers, potential customers, then you can put your ads directly on there. So Google Display Network is very, very powerful. Now, number three is remarketing. This is anytime that somebody lands on your website, or there are also remarketing audiences based on people who have viewed your videos on YouTube, who have taken a particular action. You could track everybody, for example, that lands on your customer thank you page, or you can even upload lists of your customers or your prospects if you have their email addresses, and then you can start showing ads just to them. So this is a really powerful tool as well. So these are the sites that you'll, or the ads that you'll see following you around, if you will. When you're on other websites and you see something that you know you looked at, and you're like, who knew that I was checking out, AdWords training courses, and now everywhere I go, I see these ads for AdWords training courses, even when I'm on a cooking website, or even when I'm on a, CNN, I still see ads for that website that I went to. And that's because that website that you went to is paying for remarketing ads. This is really powerful. You can already probably see how powerful that can be if you can choose to only show your ads to people that have already interacted with you in some way. Number four, YouTube ads. If you're ever on YouTube, you can see they show video ads before the actual video plays. And then over on the side, they also have clickable ads. and you can have access to these as well through Google. Google owns YouTube, so you can actually run ads here based on which videos people are watching. Now, the fifth one, Google Shopping. This is going to be very, very important to you if you already have an e-commerce-based store or business. So if you do e-commerce, you should definitely be interested in Google Shopping. If you don't, then it probably doesn't really matter. These are the ads when you're looking for something that's very specifically about buying a product, like a physical product. For example, here we have fishing equipment for sale. These are the ads that show up in the top, where it basically kind of indexes an e-commerce store's inventory and puts little pictures and ads and price points. You can actually see the price of the product on the ad. So this is very powerful for e-commerce and not really relevant for most people beginning, but if you're doing e-commerce, it's very relevant. So that's where Google Shopping comes in. Now, here are the two questions that I need to ask you to be able to give you the best recommendation for where to start. Question number one, which are you? Are you a beginner or are you a kung fu master of business and advertising? If you're a beginner, you might not even have a business yet. You might just be thinking about how to build a business, or you have a business or a product, but you've never tried online ads, or maybe you've tried ads, but you haven't tried Google AdWords. You've heard people talk about it, and you know that Google is the biggest advertising network on the planet, and obviously that's a very powerful thing to be able to leverage for your business. Either way, I'm going to give you a recommendation for where to begin. Now, if you're more advanced, then you already have a profitable business or product or service or a sales process that you know works on one channel. Let's say, you send out direct mail, you send out letters and postcards to people, and you have it down to a science of how to convert people, but you want to translate that to online. I would say that's a very advanced position. Also, if you already have an advertising budget, this is going to put you in the advanced category. And especially if you're comfortable setting up ad campaigns, if you've already built ad campaigns either offline or online, then this is going to put you in the advanced category, and it's going to change recommendations for where you should begin. And the second question that I need to ask you is, do you have an audience? This includes website video visitors, email subscribers, a customer list, a prospect list, or fans or followers. So if you have a YouTube channel where you get lots of views, if you have a Facebook page where you have lots of followers, if you have a built-in community audience, these are people who have actually, not physically, but they've actually interacted with you in a tangible way. They've liked your fan page, they have messaged you, they have visited your website, they have subscribed to your newsletter, they have bought a product from you, or they've signed up for a download of some sort. Maybe they got an opt-in product. If you have an audience, this is going to change where you should start, and it's going to change which of those five types of ads you should be running. So where should you start for the highest ROI the fastest? If you're a beginner or you're advanced, the highest ROI, the best chance for ROI right away is remarketing. Now, the only catch here is you have to have an audience, or you have to have some sort of flow of people coming to your website or your app or your YouTube channel. You have to have some sort of audience already. So if you do, and this can include past customers, if you have a database of emails from people who have already bought from you, they can become your first remarketing audience. You could just start targeting them on the internet, even if you've never sent an ad to them ever before. This would be incredibly powerful. If there are people who have already bought from you, already like your product, already like your brand, your business, this is going to be amazing. This is going to be the best ROI possible. So if you have any sort of audience at all that has interacted with you, you want to start with remarketing. And secondly, whether you're beginner or advanced, you want to start with Google search ads. There are some markets that this doesn't apply to, but almost all, you want to start with Google search ads. Whether you Even if you don't even have a business, don't even have an audience, then you would want to start with Google search ads. And over here, if you're more advanced, you have some more options. I would say that Google Display Network, YouTube, and e-commerce are all for advanced. If you're starting, you don't want to start with e-commerce unless you already have an established e-commerce business. that you know your top products, you already have an inventory, catalog, et cetera. Google Display Network is massively powerful. It's huge. There's millions of websites. There's billions of impressions possible all the time. But it's very easy to spend a lot of money really fast and not get an ROI. You have to be very careful about starting out with Google Display Network. So I would avoid that until you nail your search ads first. So whether you're a beginner or advanced, start with remarketing if you have an audience. If you don't have an audience, or if you do have an audience, then the next one that you want to work on is Google search ads. So those are the top two places that you want to start with Google to start making ROI as fast as possible. There's also a caveat here. If you do happen to have a YouTube presence, then obviously YouTube ads are going to be a good place to start, but that's going to be, you're going to know that. Just like with e-commerce, if you already have an amazing YouTube presence, then yeah, start with YouTube. You know that platform really well. But if you don't worry about it. Don't think about YouTube yet. You can bring that into your tool belt later, and we'll talk more about it later. So why do I say this? Remarketing, we already talked about. It's the highest, best chance for easy ROI because those people have already taken an action. They've already committed to liking, subscribing, buying something that you've done. So whenever you reach out to them, it's just going to be such an easier sell, especially, you know, if you have a good business or you're starting a business that people are going to love, then they're going to want to interact with you more. They've already trusted you enough to give you their email or to give you their click and visit your website or to buy your product, whatever. This is going to be the best place to start for both advanced and beginners. And then next is Google search ads. And why do I say that? Not display, is because it's going to give you the best chance for having control. You're going to know exactly who is searching, and you're going to be able to target them when they're in very specific frames of mind. So we're going to cover more of that. I'm actually going to show you in the next few videos. Just keep watching the next few videos. They're going to be as short as possible, and I'm just going to show you exactly how to set up first remarketing. So even if you're starting out with no business, no website, etc., then you're going to want to start with Google search ads. But in the meantime, you might as well set up remarketing, because once you start running ads and you get people to come to your website and they start downloading your things, buying your products, then you're still going to want to do remarketing. You're going to want to do remarketing as soon as you can, no matter what. So I'm going to show you how to set up remarketing. It's pretty simple, and it's just a couple of steps. And then we're going to get into how to build your first search campaign. Now, search is also huge. I mean, think of how many people use Google on a daily basis. It's incredible. Almost everybody goes to Google at least once a day, and they look for solutions to their problems. This is the perfect place to start if you don't have any other, you know, audience, or even if you do. Either way, it's the best place to start. So I'm going to show you exactly how to set up your remarketing campaigns and get those started. And then we're going to cover all the ins and outs of search, starting from beginners. So if you've never set up a campaign, that's totally fine. If you're more advanced, you probably learned some stuff as well. So yeah, stay tuned to the next video. If you like this video, hit like, subscribe to my channel. I'm going to be making a lot of videos about how to use ad platforms and internet marketing tactics to grow your business. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.